Hey guys, Happy New Year. It's Pastor Joellen for God and Me today. I wanted to talk a little bit about what it means to have a new year and then share a short Bible story with you. I hope that you had a wonderful Christmas and that you had some time at home. But you'll see behind me, I haven't even quite taken down all my Christmas yet because I love to keep it up all the way through this particular week, which on Wednesday we had Epiphany. And so as I'm recording this for next Monday, I'm thinking about this was the week of Epiphany, and it's the week where we remember all the wise people who came to see child Jesus in the house. And in the Bible, it tells us about how they came to see Jesus and they brought him gifts. And so in our story today, I want to be sure and show you the pictures, because we think about the gifts that they brought Jesus, and we think about in this new year what gifts we bring Jesus. So I want to show you the pictures and then we'll read our story. So here we are in our children's Bible again, and this is the page where we talk about Jesus and how Jesus was born to bring joy and hope and love to the world. And I'm gonna zoom in closely. You can see Mary and Joseph and Jesus. And God gave Jesus an earthly mother and father to care for him, to love him, and to protect him. On this page in our children's Bible, you'll see the shepherds. And we talked about the shepherds probably even before Christmas, but they came after Jesus was born because the angels came to them when they were out in the field and said, "Be amazed. Don't be afraid. Go to see Jesus. Go to Bethlehem." And so the shepherds went. We also know that from far away, there was a star. And the Magi, or the wise people, followed the star, we know, for up to almost 2 years to go see Jesus. And by that time, Jesus would have been what we call a toddler. And they brought very special gifts for him: gold and frankincense and myrrh. Now, these are unusual gifts for a child, but certainly they tell us about the types of gifts that we might think about how we give gifts as well. These types of gifts were gifts of importance and wealthy gifts.
Now, we know that God wants our gifts. He wants all of us. But the best gift we can give him is our heart, is to love him with everything that we are, and to be God's, to belong, to be the beloved's. And so certainly as we think about what gifts you might give to God this year, maybe you could give him gold because, well, that is something expensive. But sometimes we give him other things like our coins, our money in our offering plate, or we give him the gifts of kindness as we love other people in our classrooms. Now, frankincense and myrrh were really strange gifts for a young child. These were gifts of oils and perfumes. And some people think these were gifts that would predict and tell about Jesus's future, which they certainly may have. But they were also special gifts that bring healing and wholeness. Now, I have a little tiny bottle, like little, of myrrh. And myrrh is a special kind of oil that I sometimes put like on my shoulders or my knees where I have like achy body parts. And when my shoulder's hurting or my knee's hurting, it helps to heal. And we think of Jesus as a healer, as one who came not only to heal our body parts, but also to heal our souls, to heal our hearts, that we might know how much God loves us. So think about, what can you do for God this year? What kind of gift would you bring him? Would you bring God the gift of kindness by loving your family and being kind to your brothers and sisters? Or maybe you would give him the gift of hope, and you might make cards for other people this year to remind them they are loved. Or maybe you might give God your helping hand. So you might help with some projects this year, or you might do something for God this year that would help God in many different ways. So one thing that I do to help God is every Thursday, and we have Food Net. I see some of you out there. We share with people in our community who need food, the gift of food. And my job is not a hard job. I sit in a chair and I take people's name and I find out how many people they need help with for food. But mostly I just love them for who they are, just who they are each week. And I say hello and how is their family and how is their new year. And so this is one thing that I do for God. I give the gift of my time that will help him help other people. So think about how you might help God this year and this week. Let us pray. Dear sweet and holy Jesus, we thank you for the many gifts that you give to each of us. Gifts of love, gifts of family, gifts of community and teachers who care for us and teach us. Help us, God, in the coming year to give back to you of our time, our talents, our treasure, our service, and our witness. Help us to love you more each day. It's in your name we pray and say together. Amen. Hope you guys have a great week, and I look forward to seeing you soon. Bye-bye.